Hi, my name is Riata Scott, and I'm with the Division of IT's IT Training Department at the University of Missouri, Columbia. Today I'm going to show you how to insert data from a data source, like a comma-separated or tab-delimited file, into a text frame in an InDesign file. Our document is a letter-sized, double-sided booklet, and when we print it, we can fold it in half so it has a front cover on one side, and this mailer on the back side, and the inside will have the contents. This is a text frame, so if I double click that, I switch to my type tool and my cursor is already blinking in here. And this is where we'll put the data set from the records that we're going to open in just a moment. So to open that, we'll go to Window, hover Utilities, and choose Data Merge. And that opens this Data Merge panel. And it has instructions here on how to get it to work. If you forget what I tell you here, it's right there. We'll click the panel menu and choose Select Data Source. And this is the one I want, subscribers.csv. So I'll select that, click Open. And then you can see that it has put the headers from the fields on my CSV file here. And let me just show you what that looks like. So this is just a regular TXT file, text file, that I created in Notepad, and then I saved it as .csv instead of .txt because that's necessary to get these things to recognize what you have here. So the first line shows first name, comma, last name, comma, street, comma, city, comma, state, comma, zip, comma, email. And then the lines after that, each comma should, each entry before a comma should correspond with whatever's up here that creates our columns. So we have first name, last name, address, city, state, zip, and email address. And by the way, these names are real. These are all the trainers that work for IT. Kyle, David, Mel, and myself, Riata. But all the addresses and everything are fake. So just so you know. Okay, so again, we'll make sure our cursor's blinking in here, and the first thing we do is just click whichever field we want to add here. And in this case, I want to add first name, and then I'll press the space bar on my keyboard before I click last name. Then I'll press enter on the keyboard to do the next line, and I just need street there. And I'll press enter, click city, press comma on my keyboard, and space, state, space, zip. All right, so everything's there the way we need it. We can click the preview box here so we can actually see what's going on here. And there's my name, and it's showing me the fourth record already. Usually it shows the first, but I think because I ran through this a few times before I started recording, it showed me the fourth record. But this is a controller here, so we can go through our records. And if I click here, I can go through one at a time. There's Mel, there's David, there's Kyle, or you can go all the way to the bottom. We only have four record sets here, just because we wanted to make this a little easier. So we've scanned through them, we see nothing's wrong, we're good. So now we'll click the Create Merged Document button. And what it's going to do is copy all of this into a new document. We'll see a new tab up here. And that new document then will have four sets of these because we have four sets of records. If we had more records, it would have however many we decided to set up. So let's just go ahead with that, and I'll show you a few other things. So click that button. This is the Create Merge Document dialog, and you can make changes here. Maybe you only want to do a range of records at a time or something like that. But I'm going to accept the defaults and go ahead and just say OK. And this message popped up to let us know that there was no overset text when they merged the records. That's important to know because perhaps you have someone with a really long name or really long street address, and it's too big to fit in the text field that we created. So it's nice to know if we need to go and fix anything. So I'm just going to click OK to dismiss that. And notice that we have two documents now, the original and this one that's actually merged, and it's the same file name, but it has added a hyphen and a one. And over here in the Pages panel, we can see that here's the first document. It has all four pages, and if we double click to go to the back document, that one has Kyle's name. Go to the next one, that's David's name. The next one should be Mel's, and it is. And there's mine. So we could print this out and it'd be just ready to fold.